I'm a firm believer in life that you have to learn how to get up once you stumble. And we stumbled the last time, so there were just two things that we were talking about in our team meeting. Number one was to forget the last game. And number two, to play a complete game. Because we played three games, we haven't played a complete game yet where we played well for the entire four quarters. So I think this is the first game where we led after the first quarter and we kept the lead all throughout. And hopefully it's a sign that we're getting better and we're improving. So those are the two things that were important for us.
Coach, one big reason why you led after the first quarter was because of Marcus Douglas' aggressiveness both offensively and defensively. Can you talk about how important it is for him to come out aggressive in each game for you to have an MVP?
Yeah, well, the reason Marcus was able to dominate was because the other players did their jobs also to get him opportunities, number one. But I think number two, more importantly, the reason for our bad starts was that we weren't ready to play defense from the opening tip. And so today, if you notice, I started with a defensive lineup. With Pingris and Gabe Norwood together with Jason Castro, so you know, it allowed us to get some stops, and our entire game is predicated on our ability to run off our stops. So when we played better defense in the first quarter, it gave us a lot of opportunities, and corollary, it gave Marcus Doughty a lot of chances.
Coach, thoughts on
Ari
Pingris and Gabe Norwood?
Most important thing for Qatar is to be able to switch our thinking, because we played two teams back to back, Taipei and Japan, on similar styles. Now we have to switch our thinking back to a different style altogether. Big, bruising, physical, pounded inside basketball, and that's Qatar. And there's a reason why they're undefeated. They're a good team. This team is the core of the team that we played since 2007, so they know their stuff. And they've got a great import, but a great naturalized player in Jarvis Ace. So that's going to be a really, really tough game for us tomorrow. But we're hoping to generate some momentum from tonight.
Coach, first of all, congratulations. Gary David took a lot of heat in the last game. Talk about that decision to consciously get him back into the groove for this match.
There wasn't any conscious effort. You know, I'm a firm believer as a coach not to belabor the things too much. And I thought if I talk to him more about it, the more pressure he'll get. So we just went through our regular routines yesterday. We didn't really talk about it. But it was Gary David who told me to get him off the bench. It was just to give you an idea of the selflessness and the teammanship in this team. It was Gary David who volunteered to give up his starting spot, and he said, "Coach, get me off the bench. There are some players who are playing better. Maybe they need a better start." So that's it.
Thank you. Coach Trott, what strategy will you have in trying to defend against Jarvis Ace, who's a certified NBA veteran?
If I tell you, then it won't work.
Sorry. Coach, I noticed that many of the players on the team were trying to get David into the game. Dele Tunori was the one who was really directing him what to do, giving him a chance to get back into the room.